also passes to Bernard. Roach now in second place. Mothe falls to third. And of the rest, Hampson goes back to ninth and Raul Alcala down to 11th. And so with a week to go, the Tour de France has its new leader, Jean-Francois Bernard. From the top of Mont Ventoux, it's goodbye.
Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Ryan, and welcome to this final edition of CBS Sports Sunday telecast from France. Well, it is literally a party here in Paris today, a victory parade for the leader and a salute to the survivors. And we'll celebrate with all of France, and we'll bring you the tense battles of the past week for the right to wear the yellow jersey today. And later on CBS Sports, a dramatic change of venue, Talladega, Alabama, where Dale Earnhardt will try to widen his NASCAR points lead in the 500. And a touch of France from the Midwest, Grand Blanc, Michigan, for the final round of the Buick Open. But first, the Tour de France. And over the 26 torturous days that have led here to Paris, perhaps the most significant was last Sunday, an individual time trial, one man against the clock, uphill. The French call it the race of truth.
It's only a mountain, one of many you can see on this French country morning. But for 171 young men, it would be a place where they would dare to ask themselves the questions of greatness. This mountain where 171 came willing to pay perhaps the final price for their quest. Of the Tour de France was chiseled into these walls of rock by men willing to ask more of themselves, knowing that this time for some, the answers from their bodies would be no more. For Andy Hampston, a 25 years old from North Dakota, the day began with hopes of a climb to victory. Instead, with each push of his legs, each gasp for more air, the answer would come back, no, this would not be his year. The yellow jersey was the destiny of another. He would not be alone.
Cyclists are proud and happy to bring you the greatest bicycle race on earth. Welcome to the Tour de France.